Ladies and gentlemen, it's your boy Seun T, and we're about to do a reaction right now. So I did a reaction to Khaligraph Jones Ruby yesterday, and I got a lot of requests to do Bonny too. So right now I'm doing a reaction to Bonny. Somebody said that I do as I have turned the channel into a Khaligraph Jones channel. Not true. Go through the videos and see how many videos we've done. Right? So the problem is, I think you only you probably only click on the videos when you see a name you know. So probably that's why you feel like it's only Khaligraph Jones reactions that we do. Not true. So, however, from Kenya, he's the most is the artist we write most to. That's because there's a whole lot of requests towards his songs. We still have a lot of requests from Khaligraph Jones that I'm yet to address. I still have to address Beat It. I was to do a reaction to Beat It, but I chose to do Bonny first because this one has the most requests. Then I'm yet to do Khaligraph 2 and 3. And I want to do those two before Khaligraph 4 comes out, whenever it will come out. But too many reactions on the way. Or too many reactions. My English isn't bad. Too many reactions that I have to do before that. So yeah, right now, let's check out Bonny. So please hit the subscribe button, like, comment, subscribe. Thank you. Let's go.
Check it, Khaligraph. Check it, Khaligraph Jones.
Okay, so it's not an actual music video. It's probably just an Insta something he did in the studio, probably.
One time for the real hip hop heads, you know what it is. Yeah. Skeezer. Yeah, hey, kuna huyu boy anaitwa Bonny, nilimjua nikiwa high school. Chopi kwa daro, bright student, yeah, nice dude. Very social, he was making all the right moves.
Okay, hold up, so Bonny is not a girl, Bonny is a guy. He did say on Ruby that the night Ruby committed suicide was the same night that he met Bonny. So I thought Bonny was going to be a girl, probably like his girlfriend. So I say that on that reaction. But now I've come to find out that Bonny is not a girl. Bonny is a guy. His former classmate. Right? Nice dude. Very social. Brilliant.
Bright student. Yeah, nice dude. Very social. He was making all the right moves. A humble nigga chilled out. Na alikuwa na vibes true. Them teachers used to like him. He was stopping the class. And when I scored E's, he was getting A's on math.
Yeah, a few names from my own class, from my own secondary school time, right, comes to my mind now. A few names.
And all the other subjects, Bonny alikuwa hatari. His aid angekuwa pilot, engineer, ama daktari. Mimi nilikuwa rapper tu, chuo nilienda juu ilibidi. But Bonny was testing kufika ligi ya Jimmy Wanjigi. He had his future figured out, something I admired. Si kwa chopika Bonny, lakini alini inspire.
Okay, so Bonny had his future figured out. I'm already guessing. Okay, the beat tells me this is going to be a tragic tale. From the beat, I can sense it's going to be a tragic tale. Might be wrong, but I really sense it's going to be tragic from the beat. Let's go on. So he had his future figured out. What happens? Let's go.
And come KCSC, he passed as expected. Got an A, but still was calm and collected. We celebrated Bonny, later took apart ways. And I never saw Bonny Joe Kutoka that day. Until 5 years later, nikiwa around the tomb genie. Some punk ass nigga kanichomole ambini. Akini ambia lala chini. Toa simu na ganji. Nikadinda nikamsho buda. Unawazimu na bangi.
Alright, so the vibe I'm getting is he and Bonny parted ways. 5 years later, he met one punk ass nigga who probably challenged him. Was probably messing with him on the ways. Yeah, now and I don't understand Swahili so much. So, I don't sound Swahili at all. I only get a few of the words you teach me on this channel. So, probably he had a conflict with somebody. He probably, someone probably challenged him on the way. And then he's going to find this person is Bonny. Let's go.
Dasania Aje OG. Man, that's hella silly, bro. That's when I noticed Buddha. You saw that see me familiar. Man, you see me Bonny. The PR can notice. At 24, alikuwa na kanikako mid-40s.
Oh, shit. So, Bonny was 24, looking like he was in his mid-40s, right? That's what he said, right? Reminds me of Dave Chappelle's Sticks and Stones, about the guy who from his hood, went to study law. The guy was very, very good. Well, let's leave all that. If you've seen the Chappelle Sticks and Stones, then you understand what I'm talking about. But yeah, so Bonny has fallen on hard times from at 24, looking like he's in his mid-40s.
Ndo pia akani notice at 24 alikuwa na kanika ko mid 40s, and then I asked him what happened bona Evie, and then he told me that since things haven't been easy. Akani show vile life imemkali ya chapati, vile ali John Campo alianza miadarati. He was hella happy kushiriki ngwati, na kila weekend likuwa party after party, but party after party lazima ikuwe na madhara. Kauja jipanga vifresh ni kungoje tu wa Sara. He later got kicked out, dropped out of uni. Life inamlipisha after raha za utamaduni. Now,
okay, I've missed some things. There's a whole lot of Swahili in between, but I've missed some things. So he got kicked out of uni. Oh, okay. The vibe I'm getting, let me know if I'm wrong. The vibe I'm getting is Bonny got into the university and began to live the phone life, party after party. Am I right? Am I wrong? And things changed for my nigga, and he got kicked out of school, probably for bad grades and stuff. Let me know if I'm wrong. I don't understand the Swahili, but that's what I think he said. But let's go on, guys.
Now he's jobless, homeless, broke, nako depressed. He feels worthless, your life yake ko in a mess.
Hold up, man.
Dropped out of uni, life inamlipisha after raha za utamaduni. Now he's jobless, homeless, broke, nako depressed. He feels worthless, your life yake ko in a mess. I felt for him, but there's nothing I could have done other than kumpeleka Sanford na kumnunulia lunch.
Okay, so Bonny, hard times, past decisions. Now jobless, broke, and depressed. But the OG says there's not much I could have done for him other than something that I did not hear, and I probably buy him lunch. Yep, it happens. Dave Chappelle had a similar encounter in Sticks and Stones.
Nick can put your punch, and I wished him all the best. I'm just hoping that wherever he is, that nigga's blessed. Hoping you changed your ways, bro. Man say Bonny, man say. Hope uko fit saa hii kabe. Vijana, wacheni miadarati manze, ni mbaya. Steve Simple Boys aliwaambia.
Man, the decisions we make in life go a long way to affect us. While you are having your phone now, sometimes I think, while you're having your phone now, how much impact, what's the effect that the phone you are having now will have on you in the future? The decisions you are making now, what you are doing with your time now, what will be effect in the future? It's not uncommon to see people and then they are not doing so fine, and when someone tells you the story they were popping a few years back, maybe they were the shit a few years back, it's not uncommon. It's very, very, very common, right? So it's one of my fears too. I hope that I don't get to that place where okay, a few years from now I'm still broke, and then yeah, something like that. So we just have to make sure that every decision we make will not affect our future negatively. So that's the vibe I get from this song. So thanks for viewing, like, comment, subscribe. Tell me what you think, guys. God bless.
Jana, ajeni miadarati manze, noma. OG up in the place.
Yo, so that's the end, guys.
Pizza on the track, I'm the one that make him run. I'm the one that drop it hot. Fuck with me and you get shot. They can't get me if they plug. I'm the baddest of the luck. I'm the baddest of the luck.